We're beginning from West Africa, that great, great, great sub-region on the African continent. This is African Cocktail number 40, special edition. Special because we shall be having special people talking in this edition. First, my friends of the Universal Achievement Award, Esther Hakim, and of course, Raman Hakim. Then, our main guest we'll be talking from Maryland. Her name, Adele Christelle. I don't need to introduce her again because she's already out there. Very, very appreciated, you know, especially by music lovers from Africa. Then, when we go to South Africa, we shall be talking about a Hollywood delegation that is in that beautiful country. Solomon Atata with South Connect will be giving us details on that. Then, our man in Belgium, Titus Banyo, is already on standby. He will be reporting from that end. Then, don't forget, we shall go to Boya, Cameroon, where coming up this Sunday, there shall be a gospel music album launch. The author of that album will be talking to us in this edition of African Cocktail. Lots and lots of interesting items. Don't go away.
Nos élections, nous devons les consulter. Quand l'Afrique se porte bien, l'Occident est arrivé. Asaïde Yurukumio, yeah. Asaïde Yurukumio, Asaïde Yurukumio.
And so, all roads will lead to the city of Columbus here in Ohio on March the 22nd this year. And what will people be driving or fly to Columbus for? The answer, Universal Achievement Award. The people behind that great initiative are here with me in the studio. And at this moment, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to pause this beautiful one by Le Garages and talk to our friends of the Universal Achievement Award. Once again, Hakim Raman and Esther Raman, you're welcome.
Thank you, Ernest.
Thank you so much.
Okay, we have barely 3 weeks to go, if I'm not mistaken.
You're on the right track.
Right, so how far have we gone with the preparations?
Yes,
where are we?
Our preparation is at the tip-top shape now. So definitely all hands are on deck to ensure that we have a successful event. This morning we have spoken with all our actors coming from Africa International. We have spoken to virtually all the dignitaries that are going to honor the event. Everybody, they are ready. They are waiting. It's like 22nd is tomorrow. definitely they will jet away from Africa on the 19th and arrive at Columbus. And at that moment, entire Columbus city will catch the usual fire. The fire that will ignite entertainment in this city, because it's been dull for a while. We want to set it up and make sure that people love the city of Columbus. Things are happening here. People should look towards Columbus and no longer California.
Concretely, Esther, we need to know the people who have confirmed that they will be in Columbus. I'm talking about those big names, because like I said sometime on the show, this city usually doesn't host such big events. It should be like the first time some big names will be streaming into town, and people are anxious. So who are these people who have confirmed that they will be coming?
We have confirmation for mostly all the people in the flyer. We have confirmation from Awilo Logumba, confirmation from Kenneth Okonkwo, Ngozi Edlolu, we have Chiwe Talagu, we have Madam Kofo, Victor Olatoye, they are coming, Eva Banks, Nosa Production, Philo J, most of
Victor Osuagu. It's going to entertain you.
Stephanie
Okereke. Yes. Even though that she's loaded, she'll be here.
Yeah. Miss Igbinabo will
the
be president here.
The president of Actors Guild
of Nigeria will be here. So everybody on the flyer, there is nobody that turns us down. They are coming.
Okay. They are all coming. We shall come back to tell about other aspects of this great event. And for those of you listening to us, the stars will be here. So come out and, you know, see and commune with the people you watch on the screen and call them your idols. They will be here in Columbus come March the 22nd this year. And the event will be the Universal Achievement Award, an initiative to recognize hard work, assiduity, and of course the great works these people have done for the African continent. This is African Cocktail. Let's have some music, then we brace to move to Maryland and start our conversation with Adele Clarice. She's the main guest in this edition of the show. Also in this edition of African Cocktail, we shall be talking to Dr. Victor Olatoye, the CEO and founder of the Nollywood and African Film Critics Awards, who has been sojourning Hollywood and of course trying to seek ways and means of collaborating with his counterparts in the world's biggest film industry. He's just back from Los Angeles and he will be telling us just what transpired out there in this edition of African Cocktail. Don't go away. African Cocktail coming to you from Africa Radio with Ernest Kanjo at exactly 4 minutes past 11. Time for us to keep listening to music. Then we await our main guest in this edition.
C'est nous en rien. salarié. Grâce à Dieu, président des retraités. Grâce à Dieu, champion de judo.
Now she's very, very young, but then she has covered, you know, a great distance in the art she knows best. I'm talking about music. She's done lots and lots of great things. She has a beautiful voice. When she's on stage, the audience is held spellbound. Her name is Adele Christelle. She is Cameroonian, but then she's gone international in no time. And of course, she is hitting the apex of music. Adele Clarice is our main guest in this edition of African Cocktail. She's on standby in her Maryland base. And of course, she's going to tell us a story in this edition of African Cocktail. And at exactly 7 minutes past 11, time for us to move on to meet our main guest. And of course, that conversation which you have awaited impatiently and of course with lots of anxiety will be yours right away. So, let's move on to Maryland, where Adele is already on standby. Adele, if you are there, good morning and welcome.
Hi, Ernest. Good morning.
How are you doing, Adele Clarice?
I'm doing great. I'm excited to be on your program today.
I'm excited to have you on this show as well, Adele. So, how is the weather out there in Maryland?
Well, it's pretty cold this morning. It's actually snowing outside, so it's a hectic day. But it's fine. We get used to it every other day.
Definitely, it's going to be fine because we're going to have a great, great, great conversation on radio today.
Okay, I'm delighted.
Okay, I know who Adele Clarice is, but then there's someone out there who doesn't know yet. So could you help that person to know who this great artist is?
Well, as you all know, my name is Adele Clarice, and I've done pretty much around most places. So, I'm just a simple me. I'm very, very straightforward. And some people say I'm bossy, just a little bit, but I guess it comes as a natural thing to most people. So, I sing. And I come from a family of five. I'm the fourth child, a family with beautiful singers. And what else can I say? There's a lot to me. I'll just answer those questions when Ernest starts asking me.
Definitely. Oh. When you say you come from a family where everybody sings, I can't doubt that because when you sing, I'm moved. So just tell me, how was your childhood? Describe how, you know, you're growing up, the kind of things that marked your childhood, Adele.
Well, like I said, I come from a family of five. My mom and my dad were both in choirs, so we grew up as a singing family, a Christian singing family. So I used to sit at home. We have each and every person in my family have a different genre of style that they sing. So it really motivated me as I grew up. Yeah. So singing all the time, singing during Christmas periods, visiting people in their homes and singing has been a very great motivation. And that's why I'm in this singing thing I am in today, because it was pretty much an exciting childhood because I had a lot of friends that were singers as well. So that's pretty much my childhood. Right. Yeah.
And I understand that while you were singing, you were also doing school. Education has always been your goal, I understand. So just tell us, what is your educational background?
Well, I went to one of the best boarding schools in Cameroon, which prepared me well for the University of Boya, where I studied sociology and anthropology. I actually have a bachelor's degree in sociology and anthropology. So, and right now, I'm still in school. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to, I aspire to do my master's degree program in substance abuse and addictions counseling and another master's degree in international development because I love traveling a lot and I love helping, reaching out to help people. So I'm fascinated by people and how they act as groups and cultures and how that has changed as they meet other people across boundaries. So basically moving to the USA, well, has broadened, has open my mind to do more for my society in the future. So education is still always present in my life, and yeah, that's it.
But then without doing publicity for the boarding school in question, could you just tell us which is this boarding school?
Well, I went to Presbyterian Comprehensive Secondary School, PCSS Boyatown.
Right, okay.
I was fifth grade. Mm. I was a fifth batch, actually, sorry. So I schooled there from Form 1 to Form 4, and I moved to GHS Bukwango, where I had my Form 4 and Form 5, where I read my ordinary levels. Then I moved to Lycée Bileng Moliko, where I had my advanced levels. And, yeah, that's it.
Okay, Adele, from what I gather, you are a typical Boya bred. We shall be talking a lot about Boya and, of course, the new wave of young musicians who have sprung from this beautiful town west of the Mungo. Okay, Adele, thank you so much. I'll come back
You're
to
welcome.
You, then we shall continue this conversation. It's quite interesting.
The pleasure is all mine.
Okay, her name is Adele Clarice. She's a singer, and of course she's based here in the United States of America. She's main guest in this edition of African Cocktail. You shall get to know more about her. I'll probably come back to my friends of the Universal Achievement Award. Hakim, you double as a Nollywood actor. You are a screen figure, and your friends, you know, will be flying into Columbus from Nigeria. How are you going to feel, you know, meeting your Nollywood friends once again?
Well, these crop of stars, they are not just my friends. They are my colleagues.
Right.
Most of them are my contemporary. When I talk of contemporaries, I talk of Chief Chiwetalagu, I talk of Kenneth Okonkwo, I talk of Ngozi Ezeonu. Those are my contemporary, including Madame Kufu. And we have the younger ones also who are looking up to us, you know, to greater heights, you know, and we are giving them the support. And that's why we have invited them for this great event. The event of this magnitude deserves the attention of such crop of actors, because that is the only picture we can give Columbus.
Right.
And the Columbus will be good for it. That's the first of its kind in Columbus, and we want to put everything in the right perspective so that at the end of the day, people will talk about Universal Achievement Award. My wife, Esther Frank Raman, as the president, and definitely I'm supporting her totally to ensure that this comes out well.
Right. Okay, it's Akim's wish that the Universal Achievement Awards, number one, turns out to be a resounding success. It's definitely going to be the case. We'll come back to you, ladies and gentlemen. Time for us to listen to some music while we prepare to take on the next guest.
Mais on a 15 enfants, qu'est-ce qui se passe? On sait pas si c'est concours, tellement c'est compliqué, chacun a trois jugements. Yako,
c'est nous en projet, c'est nous en projet, c'est nous en arrière, on n'a pas quitté.
Papa dans le quartier, grâce à Dieu, président des retraités. Grâce à Dieu, champion de Ludo, de Damien Fils, champion d'Awale. Après avoir milité dans au moins 17 parties, supporté toutes les équipes. Quand il fait son bilan, Bému a tout ramassé. Son petit jeton, il a tout mis dans cheval. Plein de problèmes dans la maison, le plus dangereux, c'est la mort subite. Un repas par jour, précisément à 16h. Après ça fait ta prière, pour que demain te trouve. Quand tu regardes tous ces pétards, tu es dépassé tellement il te fait pitié. Mais lui il s'en fout, il n'a pas de problème. Il a plutôt des projets pour son deuxième mariage.
C'est nous en
And that one is titled Pauvriste. It's by Espoir 2000. an Ivorian group that talks more than it sings. Yes, that's what I enjoy, you know, with Ivorian singers, because they do talk quite much in their songs. Beautiful music coming to you from Africa Radio and from African Cocktail Edition number 40 with Ernest Kanjo, Hakim Rahman and Esther Rahman in the studio, and of course our main guest Adele Christel out there in Maryland. We shall be going to South Africa to meet Solomon Atta with South Connect, then to Belgium to meet Titus Banyo, who is in Antwerp, then to Cameroon to meet Alo Fonkem. Alo Fonkem is a gospel artist who will be releasing his album come Sunday, March 1. Then to Maryland, where Matt Atungong, who is the president of the Actors Guild and who will be facilitating the CFI meeting on March 1. Lots and lots of people to talk in this edition. Don't just go away. Nous sommes toujours avec Les Espoirs 2000, and that one is titled Abidjan. Abidjan is the capital of Ivory Coast, a very, very big city, economically very, very powerful. In fact, it's the economic nerve center of that great West African country. And so, what does life in Abidjan look like? It's just what these guys are telling us in this beautiful one titled Abidjan. And don't forget, the Ja is the Zouglou.
Ils n'ont rien oublié depuis les départements, en passant par les partis. À la place des ministres, on parle de conseil ethnique. Quand tu cherches travail, tu arrives dans le bureau. Directeur quoi au Denis ou directeur quoi au Lucas, secrétaire quoi au Chantal, c'est une affaire de quoi où. Tu veux, tu veux pas, le téléphoniste est calé.
Okay, his name is Sam E. He lives in Los Angeles. He is a young, up-and-coming Cameroonian artist who has already made great inroads in his musical career. He was our guest some time ago on this show. But then Sam E is coming back today to talk about Stuck in My Head. Stuck in My Head is his latest single, which has been out there circulating for the past couple of weeks. But then, what has been the weight of this single? Just how has it been doing in circulation is what Sam E will be telling us in this edition of African Cocktail. Don't go away.
À la place des emplois, c'est que des licenciements. Arrêtez de nous former, sinon on sera musclé. Faites très attention, parce que par la vie là, on sait quand ça commence, on sait pas quand ça finit.
At exactly 22 minutes past 11, we are going to pause that beautiful one by Espoir Desmille, titled Abidjan. Time for us to receive our next guest in this edition of African Cocktail. Like I said, he is Sam E. He is in Los Angeles. Sam E, good morning and welcome to the show.
Good morning. How are you doing?
I'm all right. And how are you?
I'm doing great. Really awesome.
Sam E. Down here. Yeah, the last time we talked on this show was, I think, January. How has it been since then?
It's really awesome. It's been a lot of progress, you know. A lot of things are happening and a lot still coming. So
I know.
Fans keep expecting more.
Right. And so, Sam E, you released your latest single on Tuesday, January the 7th, to be precise. That's over 6 weeks in circulation. So how has Stuck in My Head been doing so far?
It's been awesome. I'm really amazed at the reaction that I'm getting from fans all over the world. I'm talking from Europe, Africa, in America, in Brazil. I mean, they listen to my stuff in Chile. You know, that makes me feel great. It's awesome.
We haven't really had the opportunity to look into or talk about this video itself. I watched it and I think it was properly done. But just tell me, how long did it take you to put this package together, and just what did it entail in terms of resources?
The video, it took us practically a day. We started around 9 a.m. in the morning and ended around 10 p.m. at night. It was a lot of work for me as the artist, you know, to do. But it turned out to be something really awesome. As far as the resources, we didn't really need a lot because it was just the director, who was a very talented Hollywood director. He actually wanted something simple. He didn't want a video that, you know, have just a black guy just singing with, you know, with a lot of diamonds in his neck. You know, he wanted something unique, something that was gonna connect to nature, you know. So we chose the site like a beach. It was a very simple video, and it came out, you know, the message was just clear.
So are you satisfied with the technical and artistic quality of this video, and what would you say are the strong points, you know, in this video?
I'm really, really satisfied. The director, because when I wrote the song, there's a message that I wanted to send out there to the fans, you know, to my audience. But I think he actually, when he showed that clearly in the video, I'm so satisfied in such a way that if you listen to this video with no sound on and just watch it, you can still get the message just by watching the footage. That's how good the video is. So fans, go check it out. It's an awesome art of work.
So, have you had Stuck in My Head on CD yet? And if so, where can we find it?
We have it right now on YouTube. It's actually available on YouTube. It's going to be coming on a lot of TV channels all over the world, MTV, so many channels all over the world. That's in the next couple of weeks. We have it. It's available on YouTube. You can search it. Just Google it. You can watch it all the time right in front of you. As far as the audio, we have it available online on iTunes and Amazon and on CD Baby. It's all over the place. For digital download, the single is available online that anybody can buy it. You know, just go grab a copy right there.
Right. And so do you have plans for any public performances yet?
Yeah, I have a lot of performances coming up in a couple of weeks. I have a lot of performances here, especially in LA, at the House of Blues, at the House of Mint, specifically performances for, you know, for audiences down here in Los Angeles, which more is coming for audiences around the world. So don't, I'll be right there right in front of you. It's just a little bit of time, and we're working with all this to put, you know, to make things happen as soon as possible.
Right.
So there's a lot of performances coming up.
And so should we start thinking of the next album or single?
Yeah, we're actually working on the next single right now. We're watching, we're already putting up the crew and everything to shoot the video. We haven't shot the video yet. That's the crazy thing. But we're putting up the crew. I'm so excited because the guy that's actually working in this, is going to be directing this next single. It's a well-known director, somebody who's been in the business for a long time. And I'm really excited because I know it's going to come out really, really awesome. So there's a lot of surprises for fans. Just stay tuned to Sound Baco and the music. And there's a lot coming up. Stuck in my head was just a little tease. And there's a lot coming up.
Right. Sammy, thank you so much for stopping by to talk about Stuck in My Head. Just before you go away, one last word to your audience.
I just want to say a big thank you to everybody that loves music from Sam Ibako. It's really awesome. It makes me feel really great for, you know, to see people actually loving my music, saying good things about it, how it inspires them and stuff. Just what I wanted when I was growing up, like a little boy in Cameroon. That's just really what I mean. I'm getting the love from fans just like I wanted, and I'm so excited about it. And I just want to say thank you. Keep doing what you're doing.
Thank you so much, Sam E. Thank you so much for stopping by and telling us more about Stuck in My Head. And so, Stuck in My Head has been in circulation for the past couple of weeks, and the reaction has really been great. But for those of you out there who've never listened to it, this is your opportunity. Don't miss it. And that is the beautiful January 7th release of Sambako. It's titled Stuck in My Head. Coming to you from Africa Radio. And of course, the show is African Cocktail with Ernest Kanjo. February the 26th, 2014. Just right ahead, we shall be moving back to Maryland, where our main guest is on standby, ready to continue her beautiful story. Just on African Cocktail. Don't go away.
Yeah. Espoir 2000, la référence. Play, génie de fou.
Retour chez les Ivoiriens avec les garagistes et ils chantaient comme ça. Kuyu, Kuyu is a beautiful tune that was released way back in 2005. It was a great one. Kuyu coming to you from African Cocktail with Ernest Kanjo. We shall be moving to Maryland in a few seconds to meet our main guest, Adele Clarice. Adele Clarice is an internationally recognized young Cameroonian singer. Okay, don't just go away because there are lots and lots of interesting items coming to us this morning on the show. We shall be moving to South Africa at exactly midday, then to Belgium anytime from now, and of course to Boya, Cameroon, where Alo Fonkem will be telling us about his latest gospel album.
La valeur sûre.
Dans ces moments presque il y a son pas la peau de la mort. Deviens l'esclave de la gazelle. Et ton filet je ne souhaite à personne. Toi qui ça vient d'arriver y'a toi, y'a toi, y'a toi. Allez pour you, on a manio. Pensez à t'emmener quand t'es sur tout. Famille, ils sont tous juste pour les funérailles. Le fait juste arrêter un projet car vous abattez la monde. Vous le faites dévorer par le plus fort. Oh ma, allez pour you, oh namani, oh.
Okay, that beautiful one there titled Kuyu by Les Garagistes, an Ivorian group of international repute. Okay, Esther, Raman and Hakim are here with me in the studio, they have the Universal Achievement Award. Probably before we come to them, let's receive our main guest who, from every indication, is back on the line. Okay, so we have Adele Clarice back on the line. From Maryland. Okay, so Adele, you're welcome back.
Thank you.
Okay, I would like us to get into the crux of the matter. Let's talk music. Let's talk music, Adele. So, I understand you started singing, you know, when you were a child, but then you probably have gotten into professional singing sometime later. When was that precisely?
Well, started singing when I was 5 years old, like really seriously singing. And my family came out with a cassette for somebody's birthday. So it was really fascinating at that time because a lot of people don't used to do that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So that's it.
Let me find out something from you. Did you get into music because you actually came from a home where music was kind of an identity, or you just grew up, got into the world like any other person, came across musicians and music, then you fell in love with it?
Well, I have a lot of passion for singing. I guess it's because of my childhood experience, singing with my family and all that. And also, while growing up, I was the music prefect in all my schools, and I've been the lead vocalist at the University of Boya Orchestra. I've been the leader of Alliance Franco-Camerounaise de Boya.
Mm-hmm.
And so all those experiences really, it's an insight to show that I have a lot of passion for the music thing.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm hoping that as life goes on, I'll keep on doing it because that's what I love to do.
Okay. So which is your own, R&B, jazz, or just tell me, what is the genre you do?
Well, I do a lot of genres. I do R&B, jazz, hip hop. That's because I've been singing in orchestras before, so when I have to write a song, I'm inspired to do more than one genre so that people around the world can enjoy my music in any domain. So yeah, pretty much everywhere.
Right. I'm talking about songwriting. What has been your experience? How many songs have you written so far?
I'd say uncountable. I've written uncountable songs. I have a whole book of songs. I have friends that have been writing songs for me as well. Like MD, The Rap Monster, Will Hogg, Frank KC, M1 Studios, Emil Gumba, he's been writing. So people have been helping me in writing songs as well, as I have been writing songs. So that's it.
And when you write songs, what are the themes you take into consideration?
I like to write about happenings around the world. Mm-hmm. I also write gospel songs because I love God. And I know it's because of Him that I'm singing. And I also write, love is something that is a natural phenomenon around the world. So I write love songs as well.
Mm-hmm. Now, Adele, one of the most interesting episodes in your career is BAM. BAM is a group of young Cameroonian artists that came up at one time and it became a sensation. I would like us to talk about BAM in this edition of African Cocktail.
Okay.
Now, could you just tell me the history of BAM? How was it created? How did you become part of it?
Well, one of the greatest identities of, okay, BAM is a Cameroonian music group which I belong, and I worked on Strong until 2012 when I physically moved to the U.S. to start a career for the benefits of our listeners and the other parts of Africa. So in 2007, I traveled with BAM to Paris, did a video shoot and a production project. And it turned out to be another success story. So it was, BAM is like a family to me. We've been singing at M1 Studios and in wedding ceremonies and many places. So BAM is always on my mind if I'm doing anything, because I know I'm here to achieve more goals, that I'll meet with my group again and we'll do something greater, you know. So in Paris, we shot a video, Stand Up. It was screened for quite a long time on Trace TV. So it was a very beautiful experience. And the track was prominent on the world's leading entertainment media outfit. So, yeah, on Trace TV. You know, Trace TV is one of the most popular international TV entertainment in entertainment house and the world.
Right. sure.
Especially in Africa. So, mm-hmm.
It was
one of my greatest experiences.
Now, I vividly remember that when I came to Boya, you know, looking for the young men and women who made up this group, that was like 6 years back, there was an interesting revelation to me. BAM is spelled B-A-A-M, and you told me you were kind of using the initials, you know, of your names. Now, for the sake of our listeners, let's just know who are the members of this great, great, great group.
Well, BAM, as you said, are the initials of our name. So B, were actually four of us. Four of us represented Cameroon in Cote d'Ivoire, where we won among eight African countries, and we were first. So one of B stands for Bemore, that's Xenia. She's in South Africa now, doing great work in the entertainment and industry. A stands for Akum. My name is Akum, ADELE CLARICE Akuminda. So A stands for my name. Another A stands for Ewa, like Ewa Lawrence, the guy in the group. And M stands for Mabel.
Okay, Bemore, ADELE. No, Bemo Akum, Ewa, Ayn, Mabel, right?
Yes, right.
And the four of you are great, great, great young Cameroonian singers, you know. And I can vividly remember that you were born by the M1 studio in Moliko Boya, run by Emil Ngumba. We're going to come back to that, ADELE. But let us come back to your Paris experience. Just how was it, and how did you feel, you know, having to record in Paris?
Great, and especially with the spirit BAM had. We're like the most identified and popular Anglophone artist group, artistic group in Cameroon. So it was like, oh my God, we're stars. We won in Africa, so it was like a big thing for us. And we put our heads together to come up with a beautiful song, Stand Up, so, which is on YouTube. So in Paris, we had this free-minded attitude to work in the studio with Wayne Beckford. He did an awesome job, so that was basically it.
Right. And I understand the group is kind of dispersed, not in terms of not existing anymore, just you physically moved away from Cameroon. Xenia is in South Africa. I know that Mabel also settles around the world.
Yes.
So, do you people have plans of coming together one day and reviving this dream?
I beg your pardon, Ernest, I didn't quite get that.
Yes, I was trying to find out if, sorry, we have some background noise there, but we're going to sort that out. Right. So, ADELE, I was trying to find out from you if you have plans, you know, you and the others, of reviving this group someday. Oh, sorry about the technical hitch. We'll definitely come back to ADELE. We have some technical hitches there, some background noise that is interrupting this broadcast. Sorry about that. Okay, time for us to move back to some beautiful music. Then we try to sort things out and get back ADELE on the air.
Pays d'espoir, pays hospitalier. Si tu comprends pas français, ça veut me bati hôpital, parce que c'est à l'hôpital qu'on reçoit tous les malades.
C'est à l'hôpital qu'on reçoit tous les malades. Beautiful message there coming to you from Collectif Zouglou. It's a group of Ivorian musicians singing about the liberation of their country. And this song was released way back in 2005 when Ivory Coast suffered from some political crisis. But then all is well in that country and Ivorians can once again live in perfect peace and continue doing the art they know best. I'm talking about music. We're listening to that beautiful Zouglou piece coming to you from African Cocktail. And of course, my name is Ernest Kanjo. I'm in the studio with my friends of the Universal Achievement Award, to whom I'm going to find out just how the jury of that competition has been working so far. Akim, so
yes, Ernest, to be honest with you, our jury is a caliber of gentlemen all over Africa. They come virtually in almost all the states of in the country of Africa.
Okay.
At least half of the country in Africa are in this team. Okay. And we respect them because they don't want to be mentioned. They don't want their names to be mentioned so that people won't go after them. But I tell you, we people love what they are doing.
Right.
And we don't even have influence over them. They determine who is going to win this award.
Right.
And whoever they give is what we are flowing with. Because we want to do this thing rightly. And in addition, we have to give kudos to those who believe in Universal Achievement Award as a unique program. It's a unique program of this magnitude.
Right.
And people are falling in love with it. Kudos to our actors coming from Ghana. We talk about Prince David Osei. We talk about Ivan Nelson. We talk about Arthur Frank. We talk about Juliet Ibrahim. We talk about Vivienne Acho, who just called yesterday to be part of this program. We are looking into our issue. Definitely, we want all our stars that have meaning, that can make statement, to be part of this event. I want to tell you, those who believe and think in the right direction like us, those who believe in good product and good thinking, you know, you're a guy, you're a kind guy, I tell you, our people that are supporting this program. I'm telling you, the Universal Achievement Award is worth the while, is worth the salt, and I want you to go out there. It, time is now. Go and get your ticket at number 2077 Brookfield. You get your ticket. Or call 614-638-1952 or call 614-598-8269. The time is now. Don't be left out in the scheme of things. Come and get your ticket. The time and the clock is clicking. Kakum, 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 and we are there.
Okay, we also give shout out to my lady personal assistant, Tore Parker. Shout out to Anna Ado, our coordinator, who is taking care of all the models and everything. Then we say shout out to our DJ in Paris, Abraham Momo, Black Don, and Philo J.
And also DJ Yusuf.
DJ Yusuf, who is getting prepared. Shout out to Michael Lowe in Hong Kong. That we say thank you to them in Hong Kong that finally accept the Universal Achievement Award advertisement in their popular channel over there. God is good. We thank everybody that is publishing this award all over the world. We are very grateful and God bless everybody.
And also all those who are supporting this event, all those who are supporting, they know themselves. Ernest Opuni, Yoa Weku, every one of them, including our pastor, bishop, apostle, abortion. Oh, there's a man. Bismarck Osei Akomia is a well-known person. Reverend Foswata, and of course our mother in Israel, Linda Akomia.
God bless you all.
Okay, thank you so much, my friends from the Universal Achievement Award. And the message has gone across. We hope to have you again in the studio next week to tell us what would have transpired, you know, within the week. Okay, thank you very much, Esther and Hakim Rahman. So, ladies and gentlemen, for those of you who are just joining us, you're listening to the 40th edition of African Cocktail coming to you from Africa Radio. Still to come, we talk to Matt Atungong, the president of the Actors Guild of Cameroon, USA, who will be one of the facilitators of the Cameroon film industry come together that will take place in Maryland this Saturday. Then we shall also be talking to Alo Funkem, gospel artist, and of course his right hand person, Walter Blackson, who is a sound engineer in Maryland. Then don't forget our regular slot, South South Connect with Solomon Atta. Solomon will be telling us about a Hollywood executive that is in South Africa. I don't know what they're doing there, but we shall be told. Also, we hear that R&B hero Eminem is in that country. Don't just go away. There's much to come in this edition of African Cocktail. Let's listen to some music, then we shall be right back. Our friends of the Universal Achievement Awards have just left the sumptuous studio of Africa Radio, promising to be back next week for updates on this upcoming great event. And of course, for those of you who are out there, do join the Universal Achievement Awards. Okay, we've done our time with the Ivorians this morning. Time for us to move to Central Africa, and in Central Africa we are going to visit this great country, musically speaking. I'm talking about the DRC. We now begin our Congolese musical ride with Lucien Bokilo. Oui, Lucien Bokilo in that beautiful one titled Adija. And this is the Sukus Ja. We are in the DRC. And of course, for those of you just joining us, this is the 40th edition of African Cocktail, coming to you from Africa Radio with Ernest Kanjo. Just right ahead, we shall be talking to the president of the Actors Guild of Cameroon, USA, Matt Atungo. But then today, Matt will be telling us about the upcoming CFI meeting that takes place in Maryland this weekend. African Cocktail, coming to you from Africa Radio. This is a special dedication to my very good friend. I'm thinking of you, the White Bukari. And so our roads lead to Maryland this weekend, where filmmakers and of course artists who hail from Cameroon and of course practicing the art here in the United States of America will be meeting in their third come together. And of course, what is going to filter from that meeting is what Matt Atungong will be telling us in this edition of African Cocktail. He is right on the line. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Mr. Ernest.
How are you doing today?
I'm doing great. Thank you. And you?
I'm all right. We thank God. Okay, Matt Atungong, you are the president of the Actors Guild of Cameroon, USA branch. But I understand that this weekend you will be one of the facilitators of the Cameroon film industry come together. The Cameroon film industry kind of brings together everybody in the seventh art. Now, I would like to ask you the first question. The last time the meeting held in Texas, but then the very first meeting here in the U.S. was held in Maryland. You're going back to the same venue. Why?
Well, this is just to follow up on the first meeting and to give a feedback to those who attended and to the rest of the membership to on the progress of what was discussed during the first meeting and even the second meeting.
Right.
Just follow up.
And so, my next three questions to you will be focused on what will be developed, you know, from the agenda of the meeting. First, you say Cameroonian actors, artists, and filmmakers in the USA will be updated on the status of the CFI. That is what I saw in the poster which has been on social network. Now, not wanting to get into the details before the meeting itself, could you briefly tell us what the status of CFI USA is, as we speak?
Just to be very brief, the status of CFI at this moment is that it is a registered entity, the Internal Revenue of U.S., and also registered here in Maryland, having a non-profit organization status with a tax ID, and at this moment it is in its formation, and registration is ongoing at this time.
Now, you will be updating members on the activities carried out by CFI USA, and without asking to know what you have done this far, let me rather find out what kind of activities should an organization like yours, you know, be carrying out.
Well, CFI USA as an entity that is going to be like in the form of a guild, the most important thing is going to put together its active members towards training themselves on the various aspects of movie making, movie distribution, not only just movies, know that it's going to involve movies, music, and everything in the entertainment industry. So the main thing is to actually coordinate all the people participating in the movie industry to actually do the thing right, be good to control over the quality of the products that are being produced, and also to help to distribute these products when they reach end point. That right. is helping the distribution, linking them up with maybe the people who are able to sponsor and put in some investment into the industry.
Right. Now, still talking about activities, your deliberations also going to focus, you know, on the need for trainings and perhaps seminars to seek lasting strategies for the marketing of Cameroonian movies.
Yeah. Of course, that is one main thing right from this beginning, because a lot of things are not known at this moment. So this is a new organization, this is a new industry that is trying to come up, so a lot of training is actually needed, both to the actors themselves and to artists, and actually train the people involved in the art itself to brand themselves, to get the skills that they need to do in order to do the acting, and also distribute their products.
Yeah, and you mentioned quality earlier on, and I must say that this has been one of the things which people have been talking about, the need for movies that meet the standard. You know, there has been this controversy. Do you plan to have such topics discussed within your meetings?
Of course, that's one of the most important topics, if you may ask, if you may put it that way. If we don't have a good product, a very high quality product that will be sent out to the audience, then we are just failing right from the very beginning. So quality, quality, quality is the very first thing that we will be resonating to everybody that's involved in bringing up any product, whether it's music or it's DVDs or is movies and all. It has to be of high quality that will stand the test of the market.
Right.
Otherwise, we'll be failing right from the word go.
Now, Matt, you mentioned registration a while ago. Does anyone who has the fee to pay automatically becomes a member, or you must be an artist or a filmmaker? So who must register to become a member of CFI USA?
You must be either you're already an artist, a filmmaker, a producer, an actor, or if you are aspiring to be, then you're welcome to be a member, because that is going to put you into the arena to be able to meet with other filmmakers, with other artists, with other people, so that you'll be exposed to the moments of audition and all every other aspect that is being offered.
Now, I have this a little intriguing question to you, Matt. The production code is not mentioned on your agenda, which I have in front of me here. Is that going to be discussed as well?
The production code has always been provided, and it will always be looked into. It is a document that is ongoing in its development, so it's also going to be placed, be discussed on, as usual. It's going to be discussed about.
Right. Okay, thank you so much, Matt Atungon, for giving us details of your meeting come Saturday. But before you leave, could you just remind those who are concerned, you know, about the date, the time, probably the venue?
Yes, this meeting is actually, it could be a preparation meeting for a bigger meeting, which is going to maybe come up soon again. It's taking place on March 1st, that's this coming Saturday, starting from 7 p.m. up till 9 p.m. We're actually calling on everybody to be there on time, as we have a location that is rented. Location is at 5924 Princess Garden Parkway, Lanham, Maryland, zip code 20706.
And if someone, you know, is in, or if someone can't get there, how can they contact you?
Yeah, we have our numbers, direct numbers, the numbers direct to the facilitators. That is, that would be me and my colleague, Takusi Emmanuel.
Right.
My number is 240-676-8228, and that for Emmanuel Takusi, who is the director of the prison of directors and producers in. His number is 410-493-6427. Again, my number 240-676-8228, and that of Emmanuel is 410-493-6427.
Matt Atungon, thank you so much for stopping by and giving us this very salient information.
Thank you, my pleasure, and thank you for inviting us, inviting me. And it's a really great pleasure to see you doing all what you're doing to pull us up and at least send us to the direction of success. Thank you so much.
Okay, thank you so much. C'est grâce à Dieu qu'on fait ce qu'on fait. Merci beaucoup, mon ami et mon grand frère. That was Matt Atungon, the president of the Actors Guild of Cameroon. He will be one of the facilitators of the meeting that will pull together filmmakers and artists who hail from Central Africa. Central Africa's Cameroon. They say Cameroon is a giant of that sub-region. And talking about Cameroon, we have this Congolese artist who lived in Cameroon for quite some time. And of course, they practice their art, that is music, in Cameroon. Yet, they were Congolese. Yoka Lokito in that one title. Tupas. Tupas Yoka Lokito is coming to you from Africa Radio, and of course the show is African Cocktail at exactly 9 minutes past 12 here in the studio. We brace to take on our South Africa correspondent, and of course Solomon Atahata will be here with South Connect. This is a special dedication to my very, very good friend Monta. He's listening to us from Maryland. Well, we've been talking with Mach Atungon, the president of the Actors Guild of Cameroon. But on Saturday, Mach will be wearing a different cap. He will be facilitating the CFI meeting. That one is titled Tupas, Soul Section, beautiful music, just as beautiful as the packages we've been having from the Republic of South Africa for the past couple of weeks with our man Solomon Atahata. Solomon Atahata is back with another edition of South Connect. What a great slot, which everyone has been liking, you know. And when Solomon is on the air, it means that there is something in the air. Solomon is right here with us for this week's contribution. Solomon, you're welcome to African Cocktail this day.
Thank you, Ernest. Thank you to you and your listeners. I'm back from Lagos. Last week I was in Lagos for a brief business trip. I'm back in South Africa to a packed news week, news making week.
Right.
Ernest, for your listeners on African Cocktail, this is South Connect coming to you from Cape Town, where the finance minister has just finished making his budget speech for 2014.
Right.
The budget speech comes, Ernest, every year after the State of the Nation address that is delivered by the president. So it's time for the finance minister, Pravin Gordhan, to deliver the 2014 budget speech. Analysts were expecting most of it to focus on it being an election year this year, Ernest. But he has gone on to deliver it to a mixed reaction. Some opposition parties saying he was conservative. The others were saying that he was not generous enough in terms of boosting job creation initiatives. Ernest, that comes on the back of the President of the Republic, Jacob Zuma, has now gazetted the election date for May 7th. This means people who did not register to vote will not do so again. The election date has also been declared a public holiday in South Africa, so that everyone will have to go to the polls to vote. The IEC says there are 189 political parties registered in South Africa. Ernest, your listeners would like to know that the Economic Freedom Fighters, which is a new political kit on the block, they'll also launch, amongst other political parties, their election manifesto 3 days ago over the weekend. And this was to a packed Tembisa Stadium, to about people attending up to about 50,000 man crowd. So this is like a young political party, but gathering a lot of crowds to attend their events. Ernest, just still in the news belt, you would remember in 2013, it's precisely on Valentine's Day, 14th February, Oscar Pretorius, a Paralympian, very well-known Paralympian, in fact, an icon here, sports icon here, shot and killed his girlfriend. The case is meant to start, the trial will start on the 3rd of March. But what is interesting is that yesterday the court, Pretoria High Court, ruled that the media can cover this trial live on television, and they can cover it live. But this, I should indicate, Ernest, is a very limited media coverage. But you should also know that MultiChoice, which is the parent company for DSTV, has launched a 24-hour channel to watch and deliberate and analyze the proceedings in the High Court when this trial begins on the 3rd of March. In fact, this channel is going live on the 2nd of March.
Right. So,
Ernest, go ahead.
Yes, that should be a gloomy one there from South Africa. But I understand it's not all gloomy, because there is also sunshine. I'm talking about sunshine, Solomon. There has been this Nollywood delegation that has been exchanging its experiences with Hollywood here in the U.S. And we are going to be talking to Victor Oladeye, who is the founder of the Nollywood and African Film Critics Awards here in the U.S. just right ahead. But it looks like in South Africa, a similar thing is also happening. And I hear a delegation from Hollywood is visiting that country. What is that delegation doing there, Solomon?
Yes, Ernest, that is true. Hollywood is in South Africa. In fact, these are executives from Disney, Paramount, and the Producers Guild of America. They are being wooed to send more productions to South Africa. So there's a government agency known as the Brand SA, who are generally in charge of branding South Africa abroad. They have convened these meetings and invited these executives from Disney, Paramount, and the PGA to come to South Africa, so that as South Africa, we can show the world what we have to offer in terms of locations and production opportunity. In fact, NS, this is making South Africa trying to bolster its film production activities, especially those that come from the United States. So these executives were in Johannesburg yesterday. Tomorrow, the 27th of February, they will be in Cape Town, where they will share coffee with producers in Cape Town. In fact, the Cape Film Commission is very involved in this, so are the other film commissions in the country. And while they're in Cape Town, they would have missed out, Ernest, I should say, on a Mandela portrait auction that happened yesterday in Cape Town. according to the public broadcaster, the SABC, it is reported that the portrait sold for about R1 million, just shy of $100,000.
Right. That's interesting. And so, Solomon, we also hear South Africans, you know, will be having a great, great time with R&B hero Eminem. Eminem should be in South Africa, if I'm not mistaken.
You are not mistaken, Ernest. I think your listeners will be jealous because the whole city of Cape Town has been taken over by two stars, all of them coming from the Americas. You have fans going to Eminem at the Cape Town Stadium, and you also have fans, music lovers, more Latin American oriented, going to Carlos Santana, who are both in South Africa, and they are performing today in Cape Town. So literally, music lovers are spoiled for choice between Eminem, who is now going to be filling the Cape Town Stadium to the rafters, and Carlos Santana will be performing at the Grand Arena in Cape Town. And I must also tell your listeners that on the 1st of March, Eminem will also be performing in Johannesburg the same day as Carlos Santana. So while Carlos Santana will be at the biggest venue, the National Stadium in Johannesburg, Eminem will be performing at Ellis Park. I'm sure you would remember the history of Ellis Park being the venue and the stadium that hosted the Rugby World Cup in 1995, where former President Nelson Mandela hosted the Webb Ellis Trophy together with the then Springbok captain Francois Pienaar. That will conclude Eminem's performances in South Africa and Carlos Santana.
Right. Solomon, one of the things that caught my attention, you know, when I was in Berlin in 2010, was the love, you know, the city dwellers, you know, had for theater. Every blessed day, everyone was streaming into the theaters, you know, to watch plays. And that seems to be the case in Cape Town. I hear there's some news on that as well.
Yes, Ernest. Theater lovers in Cape Town, especially if you are a Don Carney film fan, you will be going to the Baxter Theater. She returns to the Baxter Theater in a production called Missing. This is one of the greatest stage actors in South Africa and a world-renowned performer at large. In this play, Missing, there's also Suzanne Donfort, who will be starring amongst others, and the play is directed by Jenny Honeyman. And that starts tomorrow, Ernest, and runs until the 29th of March. Yes, and if you're not really a theater lover, perhaps you want to go and check out American Hustle. You know, American Hustle, the film starring Christian Bale, Jennifer Lawrence, and Bradley Cooper, amongst others. This film opens in South Africa tomorrow. So it's the opening weekend for American Hustle. You should also know, Ernest, that American Hustle has already picked up 3 Golden Globes, including Best Picture. So South African fans will be streaming into this opening night for Hustler.
Right. Solomon, that's a beautiful package out there. And unless we see half more, then I just want to thank you so much. So how is the rest of the week going to look like, Solomon?
The weather in Cape Town is beautiful. In fact, there is no cloud in the sky, and everyone who was attending the budget speech at Parliament, they would be smiling because they can still go and have a lot of things. In fact, the design in Durba, also in Cape Town, and a lot other events are happening. And this is now one of the biggest design events that is on the African calendar. That's it for this week's edition of Southwest Connect. Only on African Cocktail, you can ask your listeners who want to get the gist from South Africa to follow me on Twitter, at Solomon Atta, one word, for all the happenings and all the entertainment news from the Cape and from South Africa as a whole. Thank you, Ernest.
Thank you, Solomon. Such a beautiful package can only come out from Solomon's notebook. Solomon is a widely traveled young Cameroonian, and whenever Solomon goes to, his eyes are sharp, his eyes are open, but then his pen doesn't rest, his ink flows. Thank you so much, Solomon, and I hope to have you again next week for yet another edition of South South Slot, only on African Cocktail. And for those of you out there, we are still with you, and lots of interesting things still coming up. We're going to talk with Victor Olatoye. We are still going to have our Belgium correspondent, Titus Banya, and Titus will probably be telling us about Batimo FM, which is a newborn in the media world. And of course, we still have our main guest, Adele Clarice, with us in this edition of the show. Let's ride on with beautiful music, and we stay in the DRC. And this one is titled Carolina, a special dedication to my very, very good friend. Call her Crystal Beauty. Okay, this is Awilo Longoma. Je dis tantôt à mon ami Crystal Beauty. Crystal Beauty, I hope you're not going to. Hey, okay. So I'm going to pause this one, but I'm going to come back to it because this is a special request by Crystal Beauty. Crystal Beauty runs the Crystal Beauty Show, and she will be one of our speakers in next week's edition of African Cocktail. But then we hear our man in Antwerp, Belgium, is on the line. So Titus, you're welcome to the show for your weekly contribution.
Yes, Ernest, good morning to our listeners out there in the United States of America, and of course, good evening to those of us out here in Belgium, specifically in Antwerp, where we are still to get a drop of snow. The temperatures range between 9 to 10 degrees with adequate sunshine witnessed today. Well, Ernest, Ms. Baratan Natasha from Mbam has been crowned Miss Cameroon Belgium. This took place last Saturday, February 22, in Brussels, in a stiff competition that brought together 10 girls representing the 10 regions of Cameroon. Yes, Ernest, away from that, we want to also say that as the countdown to the 8th of March narrows, Cameroonians look forward to a grand musical concert that will mark the International Day of the Woman, and L'Avocat de Francais de Femme, PTP, will be expected to thrill the population in a concert that coincides with his 30 years in career as a musician. Yes, Ernest, to answer the question of today, a film industry is a film industry in as much as the canons of production are respected. This sector might be classed as having grown, which is a truism in Africa. Prominent sectors like Nollywood, Gollywood, and now the Cameroon film industry are stretching high to meet up in the entertaining sector. These industries produce chunks of films each year, but what matters is the quality of the quality and the content. And if there's anything that the African film sector should learn from Hollywood, then that thing will be quality and content. I'm not in any way dismissing the fact that the African sector produces good films. But Ernest, when one watches a film that starts with a title and ends with a different one, or if a film is acted in so many parts, or a film that is marred by continuity problems, or a film whose storyline is hard to follow, then one begins to have some doubt. So therefore, Ernest, I want to propose that if anything we have to learn from the Hollywood, it should be that of quality and content. Yes, Ernest, this is the bit we gathered out here. And of course, we want to say there has been a baby in the media landscape out here. I hope you already know about Batimo FM, which is online now. And if you have any questions or clarifications, you may ask Ernest.
Probably just one question before you go away. I understand Batimo FM is on a trial broadcast currently. When do you intend to kick off with programs on the air?
Yes, effective broadcast with programs will take off next month, that's March. Actually, as of now, as we did say a few minutes ago, yeah, we are doing the test broadcast, and our technicians are doing everything possible. I want to actually laud the efforts of Marcel Adik, who happens to be the brain behind the technical aspects of the FM station. I think we are here, and we're going to do what is going to make you feel good. Of course, in Batumun FM, we say, Batumun FM, listen, feel good.
Ah, that's interesting, Titus, eh? What a beautiful way of ending your contribution from Antwerp. Thank you so much, Titus, and we wish you all the best, eh? And we know you are a man, and when I say a man, I understand what I mean, because you've always been very daring, but then very successful in whatever thing you do. So thank you very much, Titus, and we hope to have you again next week in yet another edition of African Cocktail at exactly 12:30. Time for us to go back to this beautiful one by Awile Logomba, while we prepare the ground to have Victor Ola Toye. Bojeni de la guitare, style typiquement congolaise. Lui c'est Diblo Dibala dans cette belle chanson. Ok madame, and that is a beautiful soukous piece there that was released in the 80s. And of course, it is one of those pieces that hit the mark. Diblo Dibala coming to you from African Cocktail with Ernest Kanjo this day, February the 26th, 2014. Just right ahead, we shall be moving to North Carolina to meet Victor Oluwatoye. And of course, we still have our guest with us, Adele Clarice. And of course, remember that Alo Fonken and Walter Blackson are still on standby. African Cocktail from Africa Radio. Listen to this one and just like it, eh?
Come on.
I call them the music genesis of Africa, Diblo Dibala. He's quite dexterous on his guitar. Okay, so we're moving now to Embago by Onus Mabele, a very beautiful one as well. But then we're going to pause that one because our main guest is back on the line. Adele, once again, you're welcome.
Yes.
Okay, Adele, this time around, I would like us to talk about a project in which you were quite involved, and it was a news-making one. I'm talking about the Stand Up for Haiti project. In 2010, you and a score of other Boyabese musicians, you know, took part in a song project aimed at showing compassion for victims of the Haitian earthquake. Now, when you recall this great move, do you have any inner feelings of satisfaction, you know, to have contributed to a humanitarian cause as a musician?
You mean my single, Damn Single Stand Up?
Yes. I mean the stand up you did as a project, you know, to show compassion for victims of the Haitian earthquake in 2010. You were part of that project. How do you feel years back to have been part of it?
It was a pretty much great experience, and we touched the hearts of many youths, especially in Cameroon and in Africa. So it was very successful, even though we had to take a break, but we're planning on coming out with a remix of that same song. So stay tuned, and hopefully we'll come out with a beautiful remix that everybody's going to buy.
Okay. Adele, earlier we mentioned the M1 Studio and Emil Kumba, and I would like us to talk about it. The M1 Studio is one of the pivots, you know, as far as music in Cameroon, west of the Mungo, is concerned. Virtually every artist who has made it has been a product of this
M1
studio.
It's a very, very, very successful studio. Everybody has good recommendations for that studio, and we actually grew up in M1 Studio. Like, Emil Ngumba has been a very great mentor. He brought us up to be able to do background vocals, and we're doing a great job. I've been doing a lot of background vocals now today because of Emil's help and my family as well.
Now, outside some of the artists with whom you work at the M1 Studio, and I'd like you to say something about your professional relationship with them. I'll begin with Zinia.
Zinia, I have been is my age, my and my sister. I've been working our group, stayed together, with family. So I'd say it's been a very great thing knowing her and working with her all these years. She's a very simple and smooth-going girl, and she has a beautiful voice. She has charisma, and so it's been a very great opportunity I had working with her and knowing her. So
right.
And great, it's been successful.
Okay. So in 2006, he became the first winner of the Star de Demain Song Competition. I'm talking about Achale. He's also a product of M1.
Pardon me?
Yes, I'm talking about Achale, who was the first winner of the Star de Demain Song Competition
in 2006.
Yes, just tell me, what was your relationship with Achale? I know he's also a product of that great production outfit.
Achale and myself, we were very close, especially in the studio where we had to stand behind the mic and sing. And also, before I came to the USA, we had this tour for winners of Star de Demain, the laureates of Star de Demain. So we had a tour around Cameroon and Bolowa. We went to Gandere, we went to Yaoundé, Douala, Boya. So I was touring all this while with Achale. So our relationship has been that way. Mm. And we got really close when we got into Star de Demain in 2006.
Okay. Then, in 2008, they represented Cameroon at the Kora Music Awards, and they even went up to the semifinals. I'm talking about the Bright Face. What was your relationship with them?
Well, the Bright Face is an extraordinary group. They're very, they're very interrelated and serious. So they deserve winning the Kora Awards for to represent Cameroon. So, well, it was like pretty much just so it was a great relationship we all had at that time. I think I did some background vocals in the song that they had to use at the Kora. So, Zinia was part of it. So, Zinia being part of the Bright Face means we're all family.
Right.
On the M1 Studios, yeah.
Okay. Well, what about Dr. Slay?
Dr. Slay is actually my cousin.
I never knew that.
He's my cousin.
Right.
He's a great guy, comes up with his own genre of his own style. So he does reggae and is very unpopular around the Cameroon community these days. And he's doing a great job. We work in the studio. I did his background vocals. And he went perfectly well. So wow. I hope to
Okay. Adele, I also understand that you had some professional contacts with folkloric artist Tata Kinge.
Yeah, in the field, yes, I did background vocals for Tata Kinge. I did his background vocals on stage when he had live performances with the band, and it went on great. That's
pretty
much our relationship. Singing
part,
background vocal, you know,
just
like that.
When you look back at the M1 studio days, do you kind of have some nostalgic feelings?
Pardon me?
Yes, yeah, I'm saying that when you think about this all good days with M1 and these guys you just made mention of, do you kind of have some nostalgic feelings in you?
Yeah, like every single day I spend in the U.S., I miss my life back home. I miss everything that was going on at M1 Studios, Track Zone Records, at Miss Lee Studios, and all the other studios. And M1 Studios, this family relationship was too strong. We acted like, we call Emil Uncle Emil, you know. So the relationship was so close. I missed it every single day. I missed the talent. Abigail, though, my baby, I missed all that talent back home. So, Dome, Corinne LaSalle, I missed things, like, a lot of them.
Okay. Yeah. I can feel it from your voice, Adele. Okay. Thank you so much, Adele. We'll be right
Sometimes
back.
Sometimes I say it and I want to cry.
You don't have to cry, especially on this show.
It burdens my heart.
I understand, Adele. Everyone is nostalgic. There are those good old days which we always reflect to. And we feel like just, you know, turning the hand of the clock, Adele, I'll be right back with you. Thank you so much, okay?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay, so that was our main guest, Adele Clarice, reflecting on her M1 studio days. I must say that M1 is a pivot when it comes to music production in Cameroon, west of the Mungu. We're doing everything possible to have the CEO or proprietor of that great music outfit talk on this show. I can't just count the number of productions that actually came out and were great successes thanks to this studio and this great gentleman. African Cocktail coming to you from Africa Radio. Our next stop will probably be North Carolina. And when we get to North Carolina, we shall be discovering what Victor Olatoye brought back from Beverly Hills.
Yeah.
And so a delegation of people from the world's second biggest film industry has been sojourning the world's number one, that is Hollywood, led by the CEO and founder of the Nollywood African Film Critics Awards, NAFCA, Dr. Victor Olatoye. They were in Beverly Hills last weekend, and of course they met lots and lots of people, especially those who matter in the world's biggest film industry. There were deliberations, there were face-to-face discussions, and of course some vital things were discussed, and of course some decisions were arrived at. We are going to find that out just right ahead in this edition of African Cocktail. Dr. Victor Olatoye is on standby, and we shall be getting to him very soon. Don't go away, ladies and gentlemen. But for now, enjoy this one by Onus Babele. It's titled Embargo, and it's coming to you from African Cocktail. My name is Ernest Kanjo. Don't forget that there are two great Cameroonian events coming up in the month of March here in the United States of America. First up, Maryland on the 22nd of March, where Sister Jerez, a much-awaited Cameroonian production or movie, will be premiered. And of course, a week later, it will be the time for Emmanuel Takuzi and Kenneth Ngamne, and of course, director Obed Joe to launch The Storm. Okay, we hope to have some actors and members of the production crew of both productions in next week's edition of African Cocktail. His name is Zita Niniel. And so can one conveniently start thinking that the world's number one film industry is getting interested in what is happening in the world's number two? That is a big question that will be answered in this edition of the show. Yeah. And so, like I said, last weekend we had a delegation from the Nigerian film industry, actually representing the entire continent, because when you talk Nollywood, you talk in Africa. So they were in Los Angeles to meet some people of the world's biggest film industry. And of course, at this point in time, we're going to find out just what transpired within that very big rencontre. And so Dr. Victor Olatoye is on the line. He is the CEO and founder of the Nollywood and African Film Critics Award, NAFCA. Doctor, you're welcome to African Cocktail.
Thank you for having me.
How are you doing today?
I'm doing great. How are you?
I'm all right. We thank God.
Good.
Okay, I understand that you've been really busy for the past couple of weeks, and one of the biggest agenda or biggest items, you know, on your schedule was this much talked about visit to the world's number one film industry, Hollywood. I understand you led a delegation of film critics and close collaborators to Los Angeles. First, what took you there?
Well, that's true. We went to L.A. Pretty much looking for a way to move the African film industry forward. So we went to the Savant Theater in Beverly Hills, where we're going to have the award this year. So we had to talk to the theater, sign some contracts, and meet with some producers of the award this year. So primarily we went there to sign some contracts and talk to some important people that will help us with the award and help the industry as a whole.
Right. Now, before I get to the next question, I think you just made a great revelation there that NAFCA 2014 will be held in Beverly Hills. Am I correct?
That's correct.
Why did you take that decision to take NAFCA to Hollywood?
Well, we've been thinking about this for a while, but we didn't really know how soon. We feel that for Nollywood, and when I use the term Nollywood, now referring to the entire African cinema, to really get the recognition that it deserves, you really need to go to where the actions are. And there's no better place for an award than Hollywood.
Right. And so when you introduced this idea of having the next edition of NAFCA taking place at the heart of another film industry, what was the immediate reaction from your host?
Well, actually, after NAFCA 2013, we were actually advised to bring it there. They told us that you guys need to be here. This is where the actions are. And the surprising thing is that how little people really know about Nollywood. That was surprising to me.
Right.
Some people kind of know about it, but they don't really know how big this is.
Okay. And so do you think that taking a NAFCA to where the action takes place, it kind of exposes this initiative more?
Yes, of course. Because if people don't know about you, it's kind of hard for them to help you.
Right.
If they don't know about you, they can't buy your product. And part of the problems that we're having in Nollywood right now is distribution. You know, there are a lot of people that you know produce their films 2-3 years ago and they're still not on anybody's shelf. And not because they don't want to sell these films, because nobody, you know, all the distribution channels that we have right now are kind of oversaturated.
Right.
We need to think bigger. We need to think about the American consumer. And, you know, by going to Hollywood, that will really help.
Right. Right.
But there are a lot of things happening up there.
And so you and some of your collaborators got to Los Angeles at the close of last week. Who did you meet, and what did you discuss with them on an individual and collective basis?
Yeah, we met initially. We met with the theater, and we shared our vision. They asked a lot of questions, and you know, and then they decided that we will let you do the award. Yeah, we're happy to have you here. They were really excited to find out about Nollywood and how big Nollywood is. Mm. And after that, then we took a tour of Beverly Hills to kind of see the environment, the surroundings, and all that. Since we're going to be having the award at the theater, we need to be familiarized with our environment, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And then after that, we had another meeting with a group of producers, people that have shown interest that they want to help us produce this award.
Mm.
They want it to be prestigious. They want it to be Hollywood style and class. That eventually, maybe sometimes next year, we can go live. And for us to do that, the award this year has to be almost flawless.
Hmm.
And they're willing to do that. They're willing to help us make that happen.
Right.
Which we're kind of fortunate to have a group of people who are non-Africans and actually, you know, love what we are doing and they want to help because they see the future.
Mm-hmm.
They see that this award will actually get very big, bigger than what it is right now in the future.
Mm-hmm.
And after that, we met with a couple of public relations people who want to help us with the promotion and get the word out there. We met with some, you know, members of the press, kind of like share our vision.
Mm.
And then we met with the NAPCA team. These are people that will actually be running everything in L.A.
Right.
They will be coordinating. They will be working with the producers, with the press, and whatever we have to do, whatever has to do with NAPCA, they're going to be running that.
Right.
And, of course, we met with a lot of African business leaders, too, in the area.
Mm. Now, I understand that one of the prominent face-to-face meetings you had was with the CEO of the renowned Hollywood Weekly magazine, that is Pratha Jackson. How special was this meeting, and how do you hope to utilize it to the benefit of Nollywood?
Yeah, I met with Mr. Jackson. That was really interesting, and we've been talking, you know, in the past several months. And Hollywood Weekly magazine actually is the only publisher that has a trophy from us.
Hmm.
They won a trophy last year for their help and for helping Nollywood.
Hmm.
And so talking to Mr. Jackson, he's aware of Nollywood and he has an idea about Nollywood. And as a matter of fact, he has published something, I think twice, about Nollywood in the past.
Right.
Including a cover, one of the, some of the Nollywood people were on the cover of Hollywood Weekly from, you know, I believe sometimes last year, 2012, somewhere there.
Hmm.
And so he's aware of Nollywood.
Hmm.
But I was able to tell him the real story about Nollywood and how big Nollywood is, and he was really surprised.
Right.
So Mr. Jackson was like, well, Nollywood is big, so also, you know, you need to, the promotion and the press needs to be big on Nollywood so that way you guys can really get the credit that you deserve.
Right.
So, talking to him, he is willing to help us with publicity, with you know, with promotions and with advertisement and things like that.
Hmm.
And, you know, sometimes in June, I think we're going to be at the back of the Hollywood Weekly magazine.
Hmm.
And have a story written about Nollywood and about the award.
Right.
And all this is to help us get the word out there into that environment so that way people can turn out and say, you know, hopefully we can get a lot of sponsors to help with the award. Because this year is going to be very expensive and we are aware of that.
Hmm.
And we're working hard to make sure that all those expenses are covered.
Okay, some interesting revelations there from you, Doctor. But earlier, we learned that NAFCA would be recommending some laureates of the awards to Hollywood. For what reason precisely, and what inspired you to think of this? I'm beginning to think or suspect that the current prominence of Lupita Nyong'o, that's the Kenyan actress, would be inspiring you to think that you should also recommend other actors to Hollywood.
You know, we're really proud of her, and every time that we have an African, you know, on the world stage, I mean, you know, I know Mama Africa is really proud. She's inspiring. Yes, that's part of it. And also, we know that there are a lot of talented African actors throughout Africa. And I personally believe that the only thing that is missing is the opportunity.
Right.
So, since we are moving to Hollywood, and since we needed these people, and by the way, we met, you know, another talent agent with an office in Beverly Hills, and I was just talking to her about, you know, all these people that we have who are truly, truly talented. And they couldn't be, and the question is that how come they are not featured in Hollywood films? I said, well, that's what I want to know.
Right.
You know, I said, but the you know, the serious note, the thing is that the connection is not there. There's nobody pushing. Hollywood doesn't know about these people, and if they don't know about them, they cannot utilize them. Not because they're not talented, they just don't have the opportunity, they don't have the exposure. And she was like, well, you know, I want to work with your organization, you know, if you can recommend some people and all that, we manage them, and, you know, and she mentioned about a couple of other shows that she, you know, she's she has business relationship with their producers, and say, hey, I can get a couple of these guys in this movie. And I'm like, wow. You know, I said, yeah, sure, let's do that. I said, when I go back home, you know, we're going to put some names together and all that. We contact them, let them know what's about to happen. You know, we're about changing people's lives. You know, I said, I love the idea, and that's exactly what we're going to do.
Right.
So, and that's how that came up, you know, came about. And so we're about to change people's lives, and we hope we can.
Now, Dr. Olatoye, on a contrary perspective, some observers have been wondering, you know, if a Nollywood Hollywood come together is necessary at a time, you know, they think that the Nigerian film industry has come of age. So they're asking the question, do you really have to stretch a hand to Hollywood?
Of course. I mean, trying to collaborate with Hollywood is always a good thing. You know, Nollywood has been, you know, doing it for 20 years. They've done all they could do, and they continue to try. But one thing is that if you have somebody that is bigger than you that can help you grow better, there's nothing wrong with that. And in a lot of films, there's been a lot of collaborations in a lot of Nollywood and Hollywood films.
Right.
That are produced by Africans. You know, films like Turning Point, One Night in Vegas, Sentimental Value, Inali, Dr. Bello, where we have Nollywood and Hollywood actors. But that is already happening. But what is not happening is that, okay, Africans, we promote Hollywood films all day long. We watch all these films coming from Hollywood. But it's not the same on the other side. So, you know, I believe that, you know, Nollywood or the African cinema deserve to get a little bit, we need to get some shine too, you know, don't you think? You know, so
right.
I believe that the collaboration is necessary and to help Nollywood get to the next level.
Okay, Doctor, thank you so much. We're about to run off this conversation. Just before you go away, what is the latest from NAFCA 2014?
Well, the latest, pretty much, I kind of revealed earlier in the conversation is that we're going to Beverly Hills at we're going to Savan Theater in Beverly Hills, and that's where the award is going to be on the 13th of September, 2014.
Right.
And we want all our brothers and sisters to join us, and we will be reaching out to Africans in Hollywood too to be part of this event because. You know, they've been doing it for years, and we want them to be part of this historic event and come and celebrate with their other brothers and sisters trying to make it to Hollywood, too. And we're truly blessed, and we're happy. And we just want all Africans to support us and, you know, spread the word. And I really, really appreciate this opportunity to get to tell our story and let you know what's going on and talk to your audience.
Doctor, thank you so much for those updates, and we hope to have you again on this show, perhaps before NAFCA 2014.
Okay, sure. Thank you.
Okay, that was Dr. Victor Olatoye. He's a film critic par excellence. He's done more than 500 film reviews, and he has this vision to give Nollywood a proper recognition. And if the African film industry is already being recognized within the circles of the world's number one, then I think Nollywood and Africa have gone places. This is African Cocktail. Don't go away. We shall be running off soon, but we still have some people to talk to us. Allo, Funkem, and of course, Walter Blackson. Then we shall be running off with our guests as well. Listen to this one.
Everything's messed up, that's for sure. People suffering that I don't know. I look around, everything seems so slow. We're struggling, no resort. The same problems never resolved. This hustle is for nothing, nothing, nothing.
Take it slow, we will find a way to get out of this. All we should do is believe. Let go. Don't be afraid, it'll be alright. Don't give up. Everything, everything's gonna be just fine.
And of course, this is that beautiful tune that featured on the world's number one entertainment TV channel, Trace, for quite some time. That was precisely in 2008. Something like 2008, 2009. And of course, you're listening to the beautiful voice of our main guest, Adele Clarice. Yeah, the handiwork of Adele, Larry, and of course Mabel in that beautiful one titled Stand Up. Just right ahead, we shall be going back to Maryland to meet our main guest, but not before we talk to Walter Blackson and Allo Funkem, who are preparing the ground to launch a gospel music album come Sunday in Upper Farms, Boya. We're in the southwest region of Cameroon. We're still listening there to Adele Clarice, and this one is titled Lost and Gone.
Life is complicated. I cannot change destiny anymore. I cannot turn back hands of time. I don't know why things have to be this way. Oh, why? Everything looks so different now. My all is
écoute la belle voix de celle qu'on reçoit ce jour à Africa Cocktail. Elle s'appelle Adele Clarice. And that one is titled Lost and Gone. African Cocktail coming to you from Africa Radio.
Somebody tell me why do things have to be this way?
Exactly 1:19, and we are trying to connect Boya, that is in Cameroon, West or Central Africa. So just be patient, and anytime from now, we shall be getting Allo Funkem, who will be speaking from that great town, Cameroon, west of the Mongo. And like I said, he is a gospel music artist who is planning to launch his album this Sunday at Upper Farms, Boya. So we will be getting him online just right ahead.
Where I've been in the scene, back on it again. I'ma take my place, never gonna believe it, I'm back on the stage. Rock, 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 I'ma never be the same. This is my thing, let's go this way.
And this is her thing, the thing she knows best, that is music. Adele Clarice, in that beautiful one, the title, This Is My Thing, coming to you from Africa Radio with Ernest Kanjo, 20 minutes past one. And of course, we are playing the last segment of this edition of this very great show. Special thanks to Dr. Victor Olatoye, who joined us in this edition to tell us about the Hollywood-Nollywood Union. I'm also thinking of you, Solomon Atta, with that very rich package from the Republic of South Africa. And to you, my very good friend and boss of Batimou FM. I'm talking about Titus Banyo, who filed in from Antwerp, Belgium. Not forgetting my strong man, Isaac Maxell, who is working in the background and, of course, behind the scenes to make this show a great one.
Keep on fighting, fighting. Oh. Hey,
Okay, while we are trying to connect Boya, we will definitely go back to Maryland and continue our conversation with our main guest, Adele Clarice, whose beautiful voice they are. This is my thing you are listening to at this moment. And that one is titled Hello. We are still with our main guest, Adele Clarice.
Remember those walls I built? Baby, they are tumbling down. And didn't even put up a fight. They didn't even make the sound. I found a way to let you in, but I never really had a doubt. In the letter, yo, hello, I got my angel now. It's like I've been a weekend. Every rule I had you breaking is the risk that I'm taking. I ain't never gonna shut you out.
Okay, in a couple of seconds, we shall be running off this segment that constitutes the songs specially selected on behalf of our main guest, Adele Clarice. Beautiful songs, of course. And when we're done with that, we shall move back to our Makossa music ride. Then we shall keep waiting for Alofonke, who is expected to reach us from Boya, Cameroon. But then Adele Clarice is still with us. I understand we also have some difficulties getting back to Maryland. But then everything will be okay. Right. So let's begin our Makossa ride with Bendeka in that one titled Eme. Now, meantime, the world celebrates the International Day for Women, Women's Day, as a matter of fact, on March the 8th. But prior to that, we shall be running a special edition of African Cocktail devoted to women. We are expecting to have a panel of successful women tell their stories. And if you are out there listening to us and you feel that you have a story to tell, don't hesitate. Just get in contact with us. We are going to sign you up for that very special edition of the show. You can call 614-500-1232. 614-500-1232. Or you contact Ernest Kanjo on Facebook. Or you contact Africa Radio.
Kwadi bende ne konye O manyongo nde O manyongo konde Na peta nende musia nae
And this beautiful piece can only come from Bendeka. He's known for doing some very, very fascinating songs. We have indications that Alofonke will be online from Boya in a very short while. So just be patient with us. Do not go away.
No.
Okay, and so after a hard struggle, we have succeeded to get to our guest at large in Boya, Cameroon. His name is Alo Funkem, and like I said, he's a gospel artist, one of the pioneers of Glory Drops. But then he has come out this time powerfully, and he is making public a new gospel music album. He joins us to talk about it on African Cocktail this day. Walter Blackson is also part of this discussion. Gentlemen, you are welcome to the show.
Thank you very much, Ernest.
Okay, I just want to confirm that Alo Funkem is getting us from Boya. Are you there, Alo?
Yes, I'm getting you 5 on 5.
Great, thanks so much. So, how is Boya this evening?
It's fine, it's cool, no rain, so it's quite good.
Okay, I understand you guys were very busy with the visit of Cameroon's chief executive. So, things are settling down after this visit.
We spent 5 days with us here, and it wasn't an easy moment, you know. A lot had to go to stand still, but it's over now. So, life continues.
Great. Let me turn back to Waters. Waters, are you there?
I'm here.
Right, okay. So, Alo Funkem, I understand you are a gospel music artist, and you have a product which you are about to dish out to the public. And also, I said earlier on that you are one of the pioneers of Glory Drops, a cappella band. You just completed this album, which you are about to make public. Is this the first time you are going solo?
Yes, it is the first time I'm going solo, in fact, because any other time I've been to the studio, it's either been with the Glory or trying to back up some other person. It's the first time I'm doing an album alone.
Right. And so I see it's a 10-track album, carefully packaged, and I assume it has taken you quite some time to bring it together. Could you tell us, for how long did you work on this project?
In fact, my life is built on writing music, so I keep writing songs. The songs that are in this album, I would say, span over a period of about 10 years, because I selected songs I wrote as far back as 1998, and edited songs I wrote as far back as 2008, so that's really 10 years. I just maybe did a little touches here and there.
Right. Okay, let me turn to Walter Blackson, who is a sound engineer par excellence. Walter, I see you did the additional recording, mixing and mastering of this 10-song album. This means there was quite some sleepless nights spent on the job.
Yeah, it's a lot of work. You know, recording, mixing, mastering is never a joke, so it's something you got to take a lot of time, put in a lot of hours. So yes, I did put some hours in, but thanks to God, it came out just, you know, the way we looked at.
Just to tell our listeners that Walter and Alo, you know, they are some of the pioneer members of the Glory Drops a cappella band, which actually held Cameroon spellbound a couple of years back. Walter, I'll stay with you to say that when I look at the album jacket, I see you brought in some gentlemen and ladies who did the background vocals, you know, in the album. I'm talking about Naomi Achu, I see Quinta Emelda, Elvis and Bethany. Why the choice of these singers?
We had to do it two ways. One, we had to record some vocals in Cameroon. Those were done by Didif.
Right.
Manuel, and then so we had Quinta, we had the other people record, and then when I came over here, I recorded some additional vocals with Elmi and Bethany. So just to get a blend of different voices and at different times, using different types of instruments, because that's what we really wanted for this album.
Right. Okay, let me go back to Boya and meet Alo. Alo, how would you summarize the themes running across the entire album, which is titled Turn to the Light? And why must potential consumers... okay. So, why must people procure this album and listen to it?
Really, if you're going to look at the theme therein, generally it deals with a lot of prayer. It's my life experience, how I connect with God, that I write, because
plenty of time I want to talk with God, I want to connect with God for any issue, I write a piece, a song, I write a song, I put that in a song. So you find it mostly songs that are leading to prayer, songs that are trying to encouragement. You have issues that deal with you know, confidence in God, especially, yeah, trust and confidence, that will run through even in almost all the songs. Almost all the songs you have there, issue of having confidence in God all the time.
Okay, let me take back to Walter. I understand you've worked on countless albums for countless artists, but for sure, this one has its own specificities. What makes it different, technically speaking?
You know, Alo and I have gone back a long time. Alo is actually a mentor. He mentored me on a lot of stuff in music. We sang together in Glory Drops. And this album was kind of something that was meant to happen. You know, it took time, but it came at the right time. God used the right people to bring the album together. And I think it's one of those albums that you just have to get on out there and get with it, and get right. The album, especially for those who are going to be there on March 2nd. I encourage a lot of people to go to that concert, to the album launch, because it's going to be hilly over there.
It's definitely going to be hilly. Alo, I turn back to you. The album launch will happen in 3 days. How prepared are you for this event?
Yeah, we're not going to the ground. In fact, we've made quite some noise about it. Many persons have been informed. We've done some radio shows. Tomorrow we'll be on radio again. I think the next day we have schedules like that on radio. Some of the songs have been running. People have been calling. They are very interested. And in fact, originally I was like, we are going to have about 300 guests. But presently the number is over 600 as I see it.
And so how is the evening going to look like? What are you going to have featuring in the event?
You know, I have a nostalgia, a passion for Glory Drops and their cathedral music. So definitely they are going to be there to spice it up. I'll be singing with them. Some of the old guys who sang with us a long time ago will all be there to have the public. The public of Uya has not had the opportunity to have Glory Drops many times. So it's one time people are going to have them on stage again around Uya. And also there is a budding artist around my locality whom I want to project to the public. So she too will be there. Yeah, she has a release. She just did a couple of weeks back. Mm. She'll be there to do some performance. So not just me, but you have no jobs and have the lady.
And so what are you going to expect from the guests at the event?
Well, basically, I want people to have an enjoyable evening with gospel music. I want people to turn to like, you know, gospel shows. I want people to be able to entertain themselves with gospel music. And as they leave from that place, I want them to be edified. And I've really hoped that they can pick original copies of CDs, because that's one thing I'll be talking a lot about. But there's plenty of piracy around. I want people to learn to pick up original copies of CDs as they leave. But over and above that, I want them to feel the connection they can have through music to God.
And so talking about CDs, once it is officially made public, where are we going to find them?
Yeah, I have been trying to make contact with distributors around the major towns in Cameroon. Definitely, the places I'm going to make known, when what I conclude the deals, but I intend to have CDs in Tiko, in Buya, in Bamenda, in Douala, in Yaoundé, and in Kumba. I going to have get one at these places, so people can easily have the business. But then, people can also contact me directly, and I will direct them. I will tell them exactly where they can get the CDs.
Right. And here in the U.S., probably, Walter, you have the responsibility of doing the circulation.
Yes, we are working with Emmanuel Nzege, Mwalibu from Texas. We're working with a whole bunch of other people, and of course it's going to be on iTunes and on cdbaby.com or Amazon. We're going to put this music is going to be all over.
Okay, we are running off this discussion. I would just like Arlo to recapitulate. So, the date, the time, the venue?
Yeah, this gospel revolution, I call it the revolution that's going to happen in gospel music in Kanjo, will take place on Sunday, this Sunday, the 2nd of March, at exactly 5 p.m. Cameroon time, at the Catholic Church Hall, St. Anthony of Padua Catholic Church Hall in Moya Town, Lower Farms. It's going to be at 5 p.m. prompt.
Okay, 5 p.m. prompt. Join Arlo Funkem and his team to welcome the newborn. Thanks so much, Arlo, and thank you so much, Walter, for stopping by to give us this vital information.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Ernest.
Okay, those were our guests at large, Walter and Arlo. Incidentally, they created Glory Drops, the very famous a cappella band, which actually became really, really prominent in Cameroon. And like I said, Arlo will be launching his maiden solo album come Sunday, the 1st of March 2014, at Lower Farms Boya. So join him there. We are about to run off this edition of African Cocktail. Unfortunately, we had problems reaching back to Maryland to our main guest. But then I promise that conversation, we shall still have it on African Cocktails. So we are about to run off this edition. So that beautiful one by the legendary Dinabel rounds off this edition of African Cocktail, ladies and gentlemen, that came to you this day, Wednesday, February the 26th, 2014. It was a great, 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 great edition. Unfortunately, we couldn't run off with our main guest due to technical issues. But like I said, she'll be back to complete that very important conversation. We are soon running off. And so that's how we run off this special edition of African Cocktail. Of course, we're putting a full stop to this 40th edition coming to you from Africa Radio this day, Wednesday, February the 26th, 2014. It was a very big and dynamic team that kept you company this day. African Kitchen Manager, Susan A.A., Belgium Correspondent, Titus Banyo, Germany Correspondent, Adik Maxell, South Africa Correspondent, and of course, the host of South South Connect, Solomon Atta. Resource person number one, Kenneth Ngamne. Resource person number two, Suleiman Kuyate. Resource person number three, Macho Ayon. Content critic, The White Bokari. African Cocktail, online promo banner, Bo Boateng. Content monitor, Crystal Beauty of The Crystal Beauty Show. Main guest, Adele Clarice. Guest at large, Victor Olatoye. Alo Fonkem, Walter Blackson, and of course, Matt Atungong. Music supply, DJ Cash. Collaboration, Big Joe, Ambrati Coffee, Big Bo, Awal Muhammad, DJ Cash, Milola, Jari, Mayo Makinde, Saran, Coordination, Nana Ampem, Charles Bafour. I've been Ernest Kanjo, host of this edition of African Cocktail, asking you to join me again next Wednesday for yet another vibrant edition of the show. And until we meet next Wednesday, it is bye-bye, ciao, au revoir, merci, I'm gone. See you. To God be the glory.
We all got nerves.